I'm Taylor Oracle, and this is a reading for Jade and SS. Jade, thank you for the donation, by the way. Wanted to know, will they be a tax professional? And Temperance is a good start, and the Ten of Pentacles is even a better start for being a tax professional, for getting into that particular field. And I think this is going to be a good field for you. We have a good balance between, as far as the Temperance is concerned, a good balance between the numbers that are going to be required and the people skills are going to be required as well. We have a lot of different people. We have the Queen of Swords, we have the Knight of Cups, and we have the Page of Swords as well. One of the issues that you're going to have as sort of falling into this field is going to be relaying a bunch of information quickly, or relaying a bunch of information at a lower level for people to understand it. So once you get into that, once you start memorizing the taxes, once you start memorizing the tax code, it's going to be a lot of work. And this is going to be a balanced thing for you. Are you ready and are you willing to put in that type of work and put in that type of time in order to be there? Obviously, you don't have to memorize all of it at once, obviously, but over time, it's going to be a sort of a grind. And are you ready for that grind? And Temperance sort of points us to that grind is going to be, you know, fairly difficult. Now, you do have some sort of places that you can go and be a tax professional on a lower level, if that makes sense. So there are different types of tax professionals. This is going to be the full accountant that has the accounting degree. They're going to do the taxes for maybe a corporation or something like that. And then you have people maybe that work at HR Block that are not going to be that maybe can do sort of personal taxes or taxes that are simpler. And it almost seems that that's where you're going to start in. You're going to get some experience. You're going to get some knowledge of basic personal taxes, sort of the easy taxes or the lower level tax situations that certain people have. And you're going to be able to sort of practice that and get good at that. And that's going to be sort of an entry. The Page of Swords, right? The Page of Swords, we're going to leap into that, but we're going to not do it full steam, or we're going to do it a bit slower and a bit, you know, more patient as far as that goes. And there's going to be opportunities for you to do that and for you to sort of sneak into the tax realm without being the full accountant or the memorizing the full tax code at once. I'm sure that's many, many tens of thousands of pages. So again, keep the life balance, get that organized and get that fixed. Look for opportunities to do the lower level taxes or the easier taxes and see what you can sort of pull off with that and get comfortable with that. And once you're comfortable with that, so we go from sort of this page into the queen. Once you're comfortable with that, now you can start picking up more of the details. Now you can start picking up more of the complexities. And obviously, as people approach you with a more complex situation, now you can go look that up. And then the following person, now you have that life experience or that tax experience of, I did the easy way first, I graduated into the queen and in a slow, progressive manner, in a slow way. I didn't try to tackle the whole thing at once. Tackling the whole thing at once, I think it's going to be bad. And it's going to dissuade you from fully pursuing this. And it's going to be challenging in a lot of different ways. So start off, I think you'll do okay. Start off easy. Start off slow. Get the small jobs done. Get your life balance in to where you're able to do more of this. And then as you progress, I think you'll be better and better. But the Ten of Pentacles being up front really sort of shows this as being a good, stable job for you. And something that you can sort of dig into. But again, take it slow. So that is my reading for Jade. And now we'll move on to SS. SS wanted to know, will my husband move out without a fight? So apparently the husband needs to move out. And she wants to know, will he move out without a fight? Or without trouble? So the Eight of Wands, this is for SS, by the way. The Eight of Wands is a movement card. And the movement card is indeed upside down. There is a reluctance to move. I mean, master the obvious here. There's a reluctance to move, right? And it's going to be a difficult move or a difficult situation for as far as voluntarily goes. I think that that gets better as he sort of gathers up more resources, gathers up more money. But Eight of Wands being upside down basically says that he does not want to move. So the Choices card means that he's sort of waiting for more choices, or he's waiting for the right choice. And there aren't a lot of choices. The Two of Wands, or that domain, that open feeling being upside down, it may be a situation where he doesn't have a lot of choices as to where, not really where to go, but a lot of choices that he likes, or a lot of choices that he prefers as far as where to go. So limited choice selection. He's sort of waiting for the right choice, waiting for the opportunity, that place to where I have the exact choice that I want, and I'm super excited about it, and this is where I want to go. It also seems like he's gathering resources, right? The Four of Pentacles, he's gathering up resources, and until he gets those resources in hand, it's going to be a difficult move. It's going to be difficult to move. So your question, will he move? It looks like the Eight of Wands, the movement card being upside down, sort of points to he's reluctant to move at this time. And again, there's a variety of reasons. One is a lack of choice. Another is he's looking for an opportunity to move, or a better choice. And when he finds that, he's going to be more willing to move, or more willing and more cooperative as far as that goes. It's going to take some coaxing. The Queen of Wands upside down. It's going to take some coaxing. It's going to take some convincing. And a lot of times that's going to be sort of difficult, right? So it's going to take some coaxing, some convincing. Four of Pentacles, again, he's waiting for a certain amount of resources to gather up before he's going to be really excited about moving, or excited about actually leaving. As far as putting up a fight, I don't see any of those cards here. As far as causing trouble, I don't see any trouble causing here. And there's plenty of trouble causing and fight cards within here, but I just don't see it within this particular spread. But again, I'm just a random dude reading tarot, so take that as you will there. So there's your reading. Sorry to hear that you have to boot someone out, but yeah. So maybe when he gets the resources, he's going to be more convinced. Maybe when he finds the choice that he wants, he'll be more convinced. So good luck, and let us know how that goes. Hit like and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.